kids these days are a far cry from what the baby boomers and beyond were like growing up. All the whiz-bang technology, crazy terminology will leave your head spinning, apparently. Thankfully, our millennial reporter, Mitch, is here to bridge the divide. Now, last time he took some old-school tech to the kiddies, here's what's happened.
You kids will never understand the thrill of hanging up one of these phones when you're angry. It's very satisfying.
I don't want to speak to you again!
Isn't that the most fulfilling thing you've ever done? There you go. It even makes little ringing noises to do it high enough. Like, I never want to see you again. Oh, it broke.
Ouch. Well, this time he's on a mission to educate his elders with some new age tech and talk.
G'day guys, Millennial Mitch here, trying to bridge yet another generational gap. I've come down to the Hills District Bowling Club and I'm going to be hanging out with a couple of local Probus members and seeing just how left behind they feel with all the technology and terminology evolving around them.
Diane and Moira, I'm very grateful for the name tags. I don't have one, but I'm Mitch. Lovely to be here with you. Would you describe yourselves as old-fashioned or, like, up-to-date? You're keeping up.
We're trying to keep up, yes.
Do either of you have younger people in your life that use a lot of terminology that you don't quite understand, or...?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah?
Children and grandchildren.
I'm 66.
66, OK.
70.
70,
oh,
OK.
Oh, you're not.
Well, I'm about to run a couple of pieces of tech by you that are kind of very fresh on the scene. It's new technology. Are you feeling confident?
Yeah.
All right, you think you'll know what it is?
Not too sure.
Speakers.
Okay.
Bluetooth speakers.
They're speakers, aren't they? That's a speaker.
A speaker of some sort.
Music.
A hot plate.
No.
It's not a hot plate. It's actually a charger, believe it or not.
And what?
It's a charger. You know how usually
you're
plugged in.
Oh, a charger.
Or a
phone. Docking station.
It is a docking station.
There you go. So you do know it.
No wires having to plug into the phone. You just pop it there.
Yeah.
Would you dare have it on your side table, though? Would you like that your phone that close to you?
No.
No?
No, mine stays out in the kitchen. I'm not that up to date. No, I just use the wireless. Words
don't come easy to me. OK, I've got a couple of phrases that millennials use often. Do you know?
Lit.
I'm lit. I'm happy.
Lit. I'm on fire, as in lit up.
You light up the room, you lit the place up.
No, I wouldn't have a clue about that one, I'm sorry.
Would you say that this bowling club's lit?
Yeah, absolutely.
There we go. Do you have a favourite song? Do you have a favourite book? Do you have a favourite...
Yeah, you got a song. Yeah, Adele is one of my favourites.
Yeah? Well, there you go. You might say Adele.
Yeah.
Lit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
No,
she did.
You could use that with Keith Urban. Keith Urban lit.
I beg your... Keith Urban is lit.
Oh, he's lit.
I would concur.
That's a terrible word.
You don't like it?
No.
You don't see yourself using that?
No, I do not see myself using it.
Goodness. God. Yes, honest to gosh.
Honest to goodness. No.
Kick
my... Is it upside down?
No. I feel like I'm doing an eye test.
Yeah, it's like that, is it? Yeah.
Knock me out.
You got it. That's actually what it is. You're the only person that's guessed it correctly. It's honest to gosh, knock me out.
Well, there you go. To the east, up
into the west. Occur.
Yeah, I'd grab along with that. I'd go along with that, yeah.
Occur.
No, see, I'm going to fail before I even pass.
There's also an upward inflection at the end, so it's a grr.
What?
A grr.
A grr.
You nailed that.
You want some help?
A grr. A grr.
A grr.
A grr.
There we go.
Our end of year party is going to be the best ocker ever.
Okay.
You see, you just said okay. You would replace that with a grr.
No, I wouldn't.
Do you imagine yourself saying okr next time the opportunity comes up?
Doubt it very much.
What do you think that is? Do you recognise this?
Yes, I do. I've got one at home.
You do?
Yes, it's a Google, home Google.
Yes.
Everything you ask the children, they just look at you and go, hey, Google.
Which means they're finding out things about things that I wouldn't necessarily know.
Wouldn't it have been nice back in the day to be able to shout at your encyclopedias?
Yes.
Oi, what's the answer?
Yes. We can say to it, you know, when's the next bus to Queen Victoria Building, and it'll tell us.
Oh, my goodness.
that it's 5 minutes' time and et cetera, et cetera.
Don't mind me, where's my pocket?
Yeah, where?
Take it.
It's mine now. You got to get yourself one of these.
Okay.
I would offer you this, but I've already thieved it myself.
You don't know what bags means, either, do you?
Of course I know what bags means. It's like dibs, shoddy, you know?
It's mine.
Yeah, correct, correct.
Not yours, it's mine.
Well, in this scenario.
Thank you.
Boy, I've never heard of that.
No, haven't you heard of it? Isn't that a thing? It's someone invented it, and then they tried to copyright it. Was it Cardi B or is it someone else? Was it Cardi B? Yeah, it's Cardi B.
Is that before or after she wore that fascinating outfit too?
Before.
Fashion.
Yeah, after she wore the head covering outfit, it was pronounced.
Yeah. It's a cry for help, is what it is.
A cry for help, that's right. Like, I'm in here, Lassie. I'm down the mine shaft.
Yeah. Skip, get help. Skip,
we really should put a cover on that old mine shaft, Skippy.
Thank you, by the way, to the lovely members of Provis who joined us for the day at the Hills Bowling Club. Good morning to you all. Thank you.